Hi, my name's Will, and I'm a graphic designer specializing in branding, hand lettering, and logo design. And today I'm going to be showing you how you can create an infographic inside of Vectornator. The purpose of an infographic is to transform boring data into engaging and easily understandable content so you can convey information easily and fast. Now, anyone can create an infographic about anything. Today, I'm going to create an infographic about an infographic. The first thing I do when creating an infographic is start gridding it out. I'm going to start using the guides inside of Vectornator to create what's known as a modular grid. These sections are going to be where I place my content, and gridding it out, laying it out, makes it so much easier to add content in there after. The next thing I want to choose is the colors. I'm going to go for a dark color today, this sort of dark blue with a purple and then some accent colors in the end. I'm going to cover my whole artboard with this blue cover, and then I'm going to go and lock it. When you lock this, it means that you cannot select it unless you unlock it. It makes it so much easier when you need to select elements without selecting the background color. Now, as you go through this tutorial, you'll learn how to create an infographic through what I am making. So this is how I designed it. So the five steps of infographics, pick your topic. I'm talking about infographics today. So the first thing I'm going to do is pick a title. Just call it infographics. And I've made the title stand out with the color, and I've chosen a white color using the pick tool and making sure that it's not pure white, but it fits nicely within that sort of lavender color in the background. The typeface choice is DIN, condensed, D-I-N. And this is going to be my main title text. I would encourage you to only use two typefaces or two fonts within your infographic. It makes it so much easier for people to know what to read, like what's the body, what's the title. You'll thank me later. So I'm going to pick my title, which is pick your topic, off the first section. This is how you create an infographic. The first thing you need to do is pick the topic. Now, with the secondary information, I'm going to use a font called Noto Sans. This is inside of Vectornator as well. I'm going to change the size and make sure that I can add all the information that I need in there. So the topic can be anything, so find one you're interested in. So now I've got the first section of the infographic on the right. What I'm going to do on the left is add imagery. So using Vectornator's icon panel on the top right, I'm going to type in the simple word topic. Now I'm looking for an icon that's visually interesting. I'm just going to drag that in and size it up, make sure it's centered to the left, and then there we go, we've got our imagery. Now the next part is the research. So what I need to do is repeat the same process again, but I'm going to actually switch it up to make it more visually interesting. So instead of bringing the research part, the actual text part, onto the right hand side, I'm going to bring it onto the left, and we're going to reflect this. So again, I just basically take my text and the box that I used last time. I press this copy function, and this copy function allows you to copy anything that you're selecting and moving. I'm going to copy the pick your topic, bring it down to there. I'm going to change the color to a nice sort of teal color, which is an accent color for this blue. Then I'm going to add my information in the same I did before. Again, I'm going to move to the right, and on the right, I'm going to type in research, and this will give me a same icon. It's really important with infographics to have similar forms of imagery. So try and find things with patterns in or an icon pack that you can use more and more. Now I'm going to repeat the same thing across the board until we get a full layout. Now it looks pretty nice right now. I'm going to add my name at the bottom. But what we can do to make this a little bit better on the imagery side is follow some of the patterns that are already on there. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to draw some circles. Once I've drawn the circle, I'm going to use the eyedropper tool to use the background of the main imagery as the color. This will fill up the infographic shapes, so it will fill that whole section that I need it to. I'm going to change the sizing of them. I'm going to move it up and down, scale it in and out, and then I'm just going to position them away from each other in a random area that looks balanced. So again, you can hold that copy button in the select tool, and that will just copy them whenever you move them. So it makes it super easy. Now for the last one with the imagery icon on the bottom right, I'm going to use some of the square rectangle functions. So all you need to do is go to your square or your rectangle tool and make sure that that bar is all the way up to 300. And what that does is it rounds the corners. So you get these really nice round corners with every square that you're doing. And from there, you just balance it out across the page. And there you have it. We have a finished infographic. Thanks for watching. If you did enjoy and you wanted to learn more, make sure you subscribe to Vectornator.